I am Brother Stephen Elabo, welcoming you to Deeper Life Bible Church, Charlottesville, United States, a place where the undiluted Word of God is being preached. You are about to listen to our General Superintendent, Pastor W.F. Kumoye, as he comes forth to share the mind of God with you and your family. I want you to be ready. Pick up your pen and your paper and jot down important messages as they will do you good. God bless you and remain blessed.
God bless every one of you. I'm reading to you from John chapter 5. In John chapter 5, there's a story of a man. This man had a challenge. And the challenge had been on for so many years. And eventually Jesus came. You can see that if you have a place to sit. I'm reading from John chapter 5. And in John chapter 5, reading from verse 5, and a certain man was there, which had an infirmity 38 years. How many years? 38 years. When Jesus saw him lying down there, and knew that he had been there now a long time. In that case, he asked a question and says, "Wilt thou be made whole?" That means, will you be made whole? A question is coming to you tonight. Are you going to be made whole? The power of God is here tonight. And that power of God will make you whole in Jesus' name. Whole in your spirit. Whole in your soul. Whole in your body. Whole in your family. A wonder of wonders coming upon your life tonight in Jesus' name. And when Jesus said unto the man, "Wilt thou be made whole?" That man, the impotent man, he answered him and said, "Sir, I have no man when the water is troubled." Then he said, "Come to put me in water. As I am coming, another steppeth down before me." And Jesus saith unto him, look at this now, hear this one now, "Rise, take up thy bed and walk." And then the next verse, in the next verse it says, "And immediately," everybody shout immediately. Immediately, the man that was lame before was made whole. I said he was made whole. Somebody there tonight, your time has come. He was made whole. You'll be made whole in Jesus' name. And he took up his bed. And then he walked before everyone. And everybody said, "We have never seen it like this before." You will see something you have never seen. You will have something you never had. Because the power of God is coming upon your life tonight in Jesus' name. That man was beside a pool by the riverside. And as he was beside that pool, he had been waiting for a long time. An angel will come. And when that angel comes, only one person will be healed. Then he'll be waiting for another time. He had waited and waited and waited for 38 years. And there was nothing better at all. It was getting worse. He became helpless. He became hopeless. I want to tell you tonight, every helpless case will be turned around in Jesus' name. Every hopeless case is turned around tonight in Jesus' name. The man became impotent, powerless, incapable, incompetent. He couldn't do anything. He couldn't get up. He couldn't walk. He couldn't help himself. And all that weakness turned to strength. Strength is coming upon your life tonight. Power coming upon your life tonight. On a day like this is when God works the greatest wonders in our lives. Because a wonder will come upon your life in Jesus' name. I'm talking to you tonight on the glorious healing of an incurable man. The glorious healing of an incurable man. If you have gone here and there and there was no solution. If you have gone up and down and there was no healing. Thank God. The cure is here tonight. The power of the Lord is coming upon you tonight in Jesus' name. The glorious healing of an incurable man. There are three things I'm going to talk about very quickly. Number one, the great question for a suffering sinner. The great question for a suffering sinner. Christ came to him. He couldn't recognize the Lord. He didn't know the Lord. He didn't know who he was. He didn't know the power of the Lord, the strength of the Lord, the might of the Lord, the authority of the Lord. And Jesus said, "Wilt thou be made whole? Will you get well today? Will you get your healing today? That miracle you have been searching for and what you have been running about for, will you get it today?" I'm passing the same question unto you tonight. Will you be made whole? I said there, will you be made whole? I said over here, will you be made whole? It's coming upon your life tonight in Jesus' name. The great question for a suffering sinner. Point number two. In number two, we're looking at the glorious answer. The gracious answer of a seeking soul. The gracious answer of a seeking soul. Somebody who is seeking the Lord. Somebody who is seeking for solution. Somebody who says, I want to get well. I want to get better. I want a new life. I want a powerful life. All this helplessness in my life, I want it to vanish away. It will vanish away tonight in Jesus' name. And then number three is the glorious authority of our supernatural Savior. The glorious authority of our supernatural Savior. That power will work in your life today. That authority will work in your life today. Number one is the question. Number one is a great question. The great question for a suffering man. As you see what I read to you already, it says that that man had been there for a long time. And he had been there for 38 years in the problem. And it made him incapable and made him unable to do anything. And then Jesus came and Jesus said, "Wilt thou be made whole?" The question the Lord is asking you today, number one question, what's the source of the lack of your wholeness? What's the source of the lack of your wholeness? Have you ever thought about that? You're not whole. You're not complete. You're not all right. You're sick. You're suffering. And I'm asking, what's the source of this sickness? What's the origin of this sickness? Do you understand? Many people don't understand. The source of your sickness, number one, Satan. It was Satan that brought sickness, all those things upon Job. And many people today, the source of their problem is Satan. Number two, the problem is sin. Before sin came into the world, there was no sickness, but sin came and sickness came. And many people don't understand. They keep on sinning and they keep on suffering. And they keep on yielding their lives to Satan and they keep on suffering. First question, what's the source of your sickness? What's the source of your lack of wholeness? And it is sin and it is Satan. Number two, why has he not been made whole? Why has he not been made whole? He'd been looking at the river. He'd been looking for the angel. He didn't turn to Jesus Christ. And if you have been looking at something for 1 year, for 2 years, for 10 years, for 30 years, for 38 years, and there was no result, why didn't you change? Why didn't you turn around? Why didn't you understand? There's no way here. If you have been walking on that same road for such a long time, and there's no solution, turn around tonight. All those ways you have been taking, and you have been trying to find solution, and there was no solution, tonight, you'll turn around. And as you turn around, something new and something great will come upon your life in Jesus' name. Number three, how has he sought to be made whole? And how have you been seeking to be made whole? Only one way that is sought at the riverside. Only one way that he sought at the shrine. Only one way that he sought. He thought, this is supernatural also. An angel will come. I'm waiting for the angel. And it came. That river did not minister to anybody anymore. Christ has now come. It's the final sacrifice. No other sacrifice will work anymore. Christ has now come. It's greater than angels. Angels will not bring all those things to you anymore. Christ has now come. It's the final answer. It's our salvation. It's our Savior. It's the Lord and righteousness. And because Christ has now come, all those things that you depended upon in the past, all those things will not work now. Jesus is the way. And Jesus is the truth. And Jesus is the life. As we receive Jesus tonight, salvation will come. As we receive Jesus tonight, your healing will come. As we receive Jesus tonight, your deliverance will come in Jesus' name. Where did he go to secure wholeness? And where have you gone to secure wholeness? You went to the riverside. Where did you go? You went to the forest. You went to the bush. You went to the herbalist. Where have you been seeking that wholeness? He didn't get it. Nobody will get that wholeness from Satan. Nobody will get that wholeness from all those powers of darkness, because they are not there to help. They're not there to heal. They're not there to make your life better. But as you come out of that, and you know that Jesus is the way, and Jesus is the truth, and Jesus will solve your problem today. He will solve that problem in Jesus' name. Who are you looking up to for your wholeness? Who are you looking up to for your wholeness? You know what God said? He said, look unto me, all the ends of the earth, and be ye saved, for I am God, and there is none else. The Lord is saying today, look unto me, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of your faith. And today, he will set you free in Jesus' name. I come to point number two, the gracious answer for the seeking soul. When Jesus asked the question and said, will thou be made whole? The man said, I don't have any man. And while I'm coming, somebody comes before me and steps into the river. And then I lose the game. I lose my chance. I lose the opportunity. I don't have anything. And then Jesus said, rise, take up your bed and walk. It will happen tonight. I said it will happen tonight. That problem you have been carrying for a long time, a gracious answer has come. A mighty answer has come. The solution that will never fail has come to you tonight, and you will experience the power of the Lord in Jesus' name. He said, he had no man. He said, he had no means. He said, he had no miracle. He had no man. I have the Alpha and the Omega. He had no man. I have the burden bearer. He will bear your burden tonight. He had no man. I have the captain of my salvation. He had no man. I have the conqueror. The one that conquered sin. The one that conquered Satan. And the one that conquered suffering. And the one that is going to conquer for you. Somebody there, you are more than a conqueror tonight. In Jesus' name. He said, he had no man, I have the deliverer. Look at him, because he's going about and he's doing good. He'll deliver that blind man here today. He'll deliver that lame person here today. He will deliver that cancer patient here today. He will deliver that deaf and dumb person here today, because he is the deliverer. He had no man, and thank God, I have the deliverer. He had no man, I have Emmanuel. Emmanuel, God with us. Is the Almighty One. Is the one that created the heavens and the earth. Is the one that has all power to do all things. And tonight, he will do all things to your life in Jesus' name. He had no man. I have the friend of sinners. Because you see, he calls by your side. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him. I'm looking for a believer there. Whosoever believeth on him. I'm looking for a believer there. Whosoever believeth on him will not perish but have everlasting life. Are you there? I said, are you there? You have me tonight in Jesus' name. He had no man, but I have the gift of God. If you knew the gift of God, And the one that is asking you, give me water to drink, you'll give him water to drink, you'll give him your heart, you'll give him your life, you'll give him everything you've got, and he will give you the water of life. And when that water of life comes to you, you will thirst no more in Jesus' name. He had no man, I have the healer of the sick. He went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil. He had no man, I have the healer. He's going to heal you tonight. I said he's going to heal you tonight. Healing is available because we're told in Matthew chapter 8 verse 16, when the evening was come, they brought all the sick and all the lame and those who were tormented, they brought them at the feet of Jesus, and he cast out every devil with his word, and he healed them all. On the left hand side over there, he healed them all. In front of me here, he healed them all. On the right hand side over there, he healed them all, because he's going about, he's looking for you. I said he's looking for you. He will touch you there tonight. And when he touches you there tonight, he will roll all the problems of your life away in Jesus' name. He had no man, I have the intercessor. It's the one that is interceding for me. Right now, as we're here, he knows that you are there. He knows that you are there. He's interceding for you. He's saying, Father, give salvation to this one today. Father, give healing to that one today. Father, give deliverance to that one today. He has written your name on the palm of his hand. He's looking at you. He's saying, hold on, don't go. He says, hold on, don't go. I have mentioned your name to the Father. And then there's a miracle waiting for you, because he is our intercessor. He's the joy of the whole universe. Peace on earth and joy to everyone. This joy is coming to you today. You were condemned, it will justify you. You were condemned, it will acquit you. You were condemned, it will set you free. It will say, neither do I condemn you, but go and sin no more. He'll give you the power to live a new life and the power to live a righteous life in Jesus' name. Look at all. You'll be made whole, sir. I have no man. He had no man. I have the King of Kings. I have the Lord of Lords. He's the King with authority. And where the word of the King is, there is authority and there's power. And tonight, that King will come to you. He will roll all the problems away. I said he will wipe all your tears away. I said he'll take all your tears away. I said he will say, with the authority of the King and the power of the King, rise up. And you are getting up from there today. It's going to do a miracle in your life. It's going to perform the wonders in your life. The man said, I had no man. Thank God I have the Lord of Lords. I have the Lion of the tribe of Judah. I have the one that sets free. Behold, the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world is there for you. That other man, 38 years, no wonder he was suffering. He didn't understand that Jesus Christ had come. He didn't understand until a child is born. He didn't understand until his son is given. He didn't understand, and the government shall be upon his shoulder. I have no man. I have the Lion of the tribe.